foot of the throne. Heavenly Father, Lord, we celebrate you. Lord, we come to you humbled and thankful and grateful for who you are and how you have covered us and blessed us and kept us. Now, Heavenly Father, I pray, God, that you cause us to walk in the supernatural, representing you and representing you in the earth. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Well, once again, it's good to be with you for 7 for 7. Today, let's jump right in into Psalms, the 24th chapter. It says, "The earth is the Lord's, and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein." Wow. The earth, the wholeness, belongs to God. Now, the reality is that God gave that over to Adam, and Adam advocated his authority by listening to the wrong voice. And because the first Adam, if you will, did not stand where God wanted him to stand and represent, Adam gave the earth over to Satan. Thus, the second Adam, who coincidentally is Jesus, came to redeem the earth, came to get back that that was God. And it was the earth and the fullness thereof. In other words, the earth and the people, all of it belongs to God. Verse 2 says, "For he hath founded it upon the seas and established it upon the floods. Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy place? He that would have clean hands, a pure heart, who have not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sworn deceitfully, he shall receive the blessings of the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation." Man, that's powerful. But he must be the God of our salvation. He must be not just the God of our salvation, but the Lord. Not just the Savior, but the Lord of our salvation. See, here David was wanting to emphasize that to really worship God, to serve God, if you will, and to receive his blessings, we must be pursuing a pure heart. Now, all of us got need for some heart work. But are you pursuing? Are you moving closer? Are you feeling in the nudging and the urgency of the Holy Spirit? And when he tweaks you, do you allow him to adjust you? And so we pursue a pure heart, and it is manifested by us living a righteous life, if you will, and doing our best to be right. We need to be pursuing clean hands. In other words, we are not allowing the external sin and the overt sin to just run rampant in our lives, but we're trying to do all that we can do to be right. So that pure heart, it talks about our holiness. You know, have we allowed the Lord to sanctify us and to bring us closer to him? Amen. God wants us to move closer to him. God wants us to love him, right? Verse 5 says, "Lead me in thy truth and teach me thy ways." See, the danger is that many people can be saved. They can know the Lord. They can be saved and know of the Lord's acts and not really know the Lord's ways. God wants us to know his ways, right? Because when you know his ways, then you can trust God no matter what's going on. And you know, you can't always think because something negative happened that God is displeased with you, because sometimes he'll lead you, if you will, through the valley. Or, you know, ultimately he led, you know, the Father led the Son, if you will, basically to the cross. But that was for our good. So there are some things that God leads us through, and it's for kingdom glory, for the kingdom to be glorified, but it's going to work for our good, or it's for the other's gain, right? See, we got to be able to trust God and to give God the glory. No matter what's happened, we need to let God have his way. Amen. We need to let God move on our behalf. Amen. And just let the Lord take us to a deeper place. See, that was verse 20. Chapter 25, where it says, lead me in thy truth and teach me. For thou art the God of my salvation, and on thee do I wait all the day long. You got to learn to just wait on the Lord. You got to learn to just trust the Lord and to know that he's there to bring you out. Chapter 24, verse 5 says, he shall receive the blessings from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. Verse 6 says, this is the generation of them that seek. Hello? This is. He was talking then, but this is more urgent to today and necessary today. This is the generation of them that seek him, that seek thy face, O Jacob. He said, look, we need to wake up that natural man. We need to wake him up so that he can begin to seek and that he can be converted, that he can seek and see his life changed. Lift up your heads. In other words, look up, O ye gates. Be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? By the way, his name is Jesus. Who is the King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty. The Lord, mighty in battle. He fights for us. He fights for us. Lift up your heads, O ye gates. Even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Where does he want to come in? To your heart, to your life, to your situation. Let the King of glory come in and take control and know that he's going to bless you as you live a life that worships him and magnifies him. Give him some glory. Amen. Lift up your heads, O ye gates. Lift them up, ye everlasting doors. The King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Today, let the Lord take more reign and control over your life. Today, let the Lord move on your behalf. But come to him with a pure heart and clean hands. Be blessed.